The angel of the Lord declared then to Mary,
and she conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, not the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. For to beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ,
your Son, was made known
by the message of an angel, made by his passion and cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
It was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated for a while. Good evening, brothers and sisters. We are on the 33rd week in ordinary time. Today is Friday. Please all stand. Entrance antiphon. Our presider for this evening mass is Reverend Father Bipin John. Entrance antiphon. The Lord said, I think thoughts of peace and not of affliction. I will call upon you, you will call upon me, and I will answer you. And I will lead back your captives from every place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, we remember all our parishioners, all those who offer this holy mass, and we pray for them. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conform to his image, we may merit a share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard a voice from heaven speak to me. Then the voice spoke to me and said, "Go, take the scroll that lies open in the hand of the angel who is standing on the sea and on the land." So I went up to the angel and told him to give me the small scroll. He said to me, "Take and swallow it. It will turn your stomach sour, but in your mouth it will taste as sweet as honey." I took the small scroll from the angel's hand and swallowed it. In my mouth it was like sweet honey, but when I had eaten it, my stomach turned sour. Then someone said to me, "You must prophesy again about many peoples, nations, tongues, and kings." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
How sweet it to my taste is your promise.
In the way of your decrees I rejoice, as much as in all riches.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
Yes, your decrees are my delight, they are my counselors.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
How sweet to my palate are your promises, sweeter than honey to my mouth.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
Your decrees are my inheritance forever, the joy of my heart they are.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
I gasp with open mouth in my yearning for your commands.
How sweet to my taste is your promise. Please all stand in honor of the Holy Gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. My sheep hear my voice, says the Lord. I know them, and they follow me. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with yours.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus entered the temple area and proceeded to drive out those who were selling things, saying to them, "It is written, 'My house shall be a house of prayer,' but you have made it a den of thieves." And every day he was teaching in the temple area. The chief priests, the scribes, and the leaders of the people, meanwhile, were seeking to put him to death, but they could find no way to accomplish their purpose, because all the people were hanging on his words. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, yesterday we heard the Gospel. Jesus was crying for the Temple of Jerusalem. But it's not only that the destruction of the building, not Jesus was crying for the building, but Jesus was crying for the people who were really suffering, because there was no peace, and because of the disturbance in the area, in the life of the people. Jesus was crying. Today again, Jesus is in the temple, and there are stores, there are shops, lot of selling, lot of buying, and that is Jesus did not like that. And Jesus says, this is not the house for the marketplace. It is a house of prayer. Brothers and sisters, there are Pharisees, there are scribes, there are many other leaders. They could not say much anything about the temple. But Jesus speaks about the temple because Jesus has the authority. He is the Son of God. And that's why, though those people have the religious power, the muscle power, the money power, and all kind of power, but Jesus has spiritual power. And because of that spiritual power, Jesus talks about the temple. But Jesus knows that he will be tortured, he will be killed. He himself is the temple. Jesus himself is the temple. And today we are also reminded, Saint Paul says that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. And when we are the temple of the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters, today we have to just find out what are those bad habits, the sins, all those bad habits and sins that I have in my personal life, I have to just remove from my heart. And if it is the temple of the Holy Spirit, my body, Jesus is the body. And we have to just find out what are those bad habits and sins in my life. And that is the real way we can meditate on today's gospel. Let us ask the Lord that we may, for us is a good example today. Jesus is the good model for us, who is really a holy temple for all of us. It's not only the construction, not the building, not the beautiful the Jerusalem temple, but it is the real heart of Jesus. Today we go to Israel, there is no temple, there is only the area like the school ground, only the last wall is there, that also not in good condition, where people are just touching their hands and praying. Today when we go to Israel, only this wall is there. Rest all those beautiful temple, Jerusalem temple is not there. But it is a really holy place for everybody to pray. Let us ask the Lord that we may receive his grace, he may be kind for us, for our sins. Gathered together in this house of prayer, let us with confidence bring our needs before our loving Father. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church throughout the world continue to grow in faith and love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That respect for human rights be evident among the nations of its continent, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember those afflicted by addiction of any kind, that they may allow the healing touch of Jesus into their lives, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people of our parish, and especially parents, as they seek to lead their children to God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us pray for our own intentions. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Sisters and brothers, today Father Bernie is celebrating his birthday. We pray for his elderly mother, for his family members, and also we pray for Father's intentions and for his ministry. Loving Father, look with favor on these petitions which we, your people, bring before you in faith and confidence through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of our human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of our human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. O God, Father of mercies, who, because of the great love with which you loved us, with untold goodness gave us your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with him, we may offer you worthy homage through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the church sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God, and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Broderick, our administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, Jesus is reminding the people of Jerusalem. Many prophets and many good people were sent to the people by the Lord, but many were tortured, many were killed. Jesus wants good relationship with the people of Jerusalem. Jesus wants good relationship with us, all of us. Let us have good relationship with Jesus, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. May the mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring
Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you takes away the sins of the world, have grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, and the living by the will of the Father. Free us by this most holy and from all our sins and make it possible. Never let us be parted. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Communion antiphon. To be near God is my happiness. To place my hope in God, the Lord. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Maybe a healing for eternity. Let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be confirmed to Christ on earth and merit to be coheirs of his glory in heaven.
who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Please all kneel.
O Lord God omnipotent, we beseech you by the precious blood which Jesus, your divine Son, did shed this day upon the tree of the cross, especially from his sacred hands and feet, deliver the souls in purgatory for whom we are most bound to pray, in order that we may not be the cause which hinders you from admitting them quickly to the possession of your glory, where they may praise you and bless you forevermore.
Amen. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord,
and let your perpetual light shine upon them.
From the gates of hell,
deliver their souls, O Lord.
May they rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
O Lord, hear our prayer,
and let our cry come to you.
Let us pray, O God,
the Creator and Redeemer of all the faithful, Grant to the souls of your servants and handmaids the remission of all their sins, that through our devout supplication they may obtain the pardon they have always desired, who lives and reigns world without end. Amen.
May the souls of all the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Sa ngalan ng Ama at ng Anak at ng Espiritu Santo. Amen. O San Antonio, pinili ka ng Diyos na ipabatid sa daigdig ang iyong kabanalan upang maakit ang marami sa paggawa ng mga kabutihan. Hilingin mo sa sanggol na si Jesus na hawak mo sa iyong bisig ang mahigpit ko ngayong pangangailangan. Thank you. samahan mo ako sa aking panalangin, sapagkat ang dasal ng isang banal na kagaya mo ay dinirinig ng Diyos. Pagkalooban nawa ako ng Panginoon ng tanda ng kanyang pagmamahal, paggalinga at paggabay. Sa tulong mo, naway ipagkaloob niya sa akin ang kaganapan ng buhay at ang pag-ibig na walang hanggan. Amen.